What is up? Another day. More Blaze Blue. I know I've been, you know, I've been seeing a few. Yo, where's Marvel? Uh-oh. We may be out of luck here. Let's see if this is still the same. I checked about a couple hours earlier. Yep. Oh, geez, there's 10 less people. But yeah, I don't know why everybody's in the South America room, but everybody is in the South America room, so. Let's see. Neo Play, where are you? Darn. So I'm not playing that. Maddie Renpa, that's a one bar. Let's try it. If they're down, I'm down. We need to just get some matches. Man, yesterday was a disappointment. I played a bunch yesterday and I got in this lobby that had the person, like, they made it so, you know, only 3-bar or 4-bar people could join. I heard that there's actually stage lag on a lot of stages, so I need to be careful of that. But yeah, I joined this lobby where they made it so only people with 3 or 4 bars could join. There were 6 people in there. And then they made it to that thing where, like, multiple people could be playing at once, which is an awesome feature. Shoutouts to you, Arc System Works, for thinking of that. Oh, man, I played like booty. Like, they were quality players, too. All good connections, all quality players. Ooh, we have 1 bar, don't skip the intro! All quality players. And I sucked. I dropped everything. I didn't hit confirm anything correctly. I sucked. And it made me so sad. What am I doing? Oh, thanks for bursting. Ow. This connection sucks! Oh god. Why did that confirm? Bugs me that that confirmed. What? Damn it! Yay, silly Asriel damage and lag. But yeah, this connection is definitely a 1-bar connection. We have a real 1-bar connection up in her right now. Should not have done this. Dang it! Really? Is that how we're gonna play it? Darn. That was stupid of me. Ah, that was stupid of him! Darn, I didn't get a 5A out. I am so unnaturally judgmental of people that mash 5A for no good reason. I mean, like, I should not be hateful towards these people. I should not mock them for it. I should just blow them up for it. But for some reason, it makes me laugh that people just, like, literally sit there and, like it's on turbo. No, I'm not playing you again, you 1-bar. Shit! Yo, we're gonna try it. I don't care that it's 1-bar. Homie is red. I've only played 1 other red person in my life. And the connection was so depressingly bad that it wasn't even fun. I need red in my life. Because that is apparently, for the color-coded way that works, is that the red players are, like, for however that's judged, are the best players. It's like red, orange, yellow, light green, dark green, blue? I don't know. There's a light blue and a regular blue. I don't know if regular blue is first and then light blue, if it's the other way around. I think that's how it goes. This connection feels fine too, even though homie skipped the intro. Damn it, that sucks. Oops, that was bad. That was bad on me. I feel like I may have overhyped myself here. Damn it! Yo, shout out to that backdash happening. That was cool. What? I don't know why that happened. That was just bad on my part. Dude, can I get something here? Thank you. I don't even care. I don't care that I got that random ass hit. Because I deserved it. Why is this person red? Do people just get like... You know what? Damn it! What? Did this person just mash 5A on me? Why didn't it come out again? What? Stupid. Stupid. Why is that person red? I mean, like, I feel like ranked matches have a far greater impact. If not, no. Because I did go up from green to yellow through player matches. Like, I had not played ranked in a long time. I've only done 3 ranked matches regardless. But I do feel like ranked matches are far more... they affect the rank, that little status indicator thingy, significantly more than... what am I trying to say? Significantly more than player matches. Because, like, that... He didn't do anything. I mean, like, all the hits that happened right there were not from, like, anything godlike on his part. It was just from me being, like, stupid. Seriously? Really? Like, this is a terrible matchup. But yeah, all the red people I have seen have always had, like, a higher ranked rank. I very rarely see anybody that's red that, like, hasn't, that is like me, that just hasn't played ranked. But yeah, there's literally, if I lose this, this person deserves this win. I can never say, like, bad things about a Tager if they beat me, because this matchup is so utterly atrocious. I don't know why that didn't come out. But fuck getting magnet touch. That sucks. Ah, I thought he went airborne. My fault. My fault for allowing him to mash that out. See, I mean, all of this is my fault. Like, he doesn't deserve any of these hits. I mean, that was my fault too. Like, all of this is my fault. Literally none of this is, like, him being good, him doing anything special. This is all my fault. What? Why? Nothing? Like, seriously? Really? Nothing again? I mean, now it's not my fault. Now I'm confused. That was terrible. I'm not really sure what all happened right there. That was all kind of weird. See, the dude's just mashing, like, the entire time. Like, that's all he was doing the entire time with Arakuni, the entire time. This dude doesn't deserve red? This dude isn't living up to the red reputation? I was hoping for a godlike player that was gonna show me some godlike shit, and I was happy because I have not played an Arakuni player in this game. I played a little bit of White Boy Willy, but even he admits, like, he doesn't really play the game all that much. So he's kind of still basing all of his, really? Boss Maximus is a zero? I remember that being a damn good connection back when I remember that dude, because that was the very first player we ever played in this one, and then we raged, remember? Because that homie stole our spot. That dirtbag Tager. Moco. Damn, I got so happy because I thought it was the three bar! I was lied to! Fuck it, let's try it. That other one bar connect, like the connection with that other dude was fine. It was the player that we had a problem with. But yeah, I played Copper Dabbit on like the release day shit, which obviously that wasn't a good stub because he was still basing his entire gameplay around old versions of the game. Same thing with Willy, most of his stuff is based around old versions of Arakuni. He doesn't really have a lot of like new stuff, so I haven't really played like an Arakuni that utilizes any of his new stuff, whatever it is. I don't even know what he has that's new. I know he has that little, like, fake out thing, like that, where it looks like he's jumping, but then he didn't jump. Copper Davit did that to me like 20 times, and I've tried to anti air it every single fucking time. I was so mad. But yeah, Tager versus. There's no reason for Asriel to win. I legitimately think that could possibly be like 7.5, 2.5, or worse. No joke. Because, like, I'll get into it after this because I will forget everything in the middle of the match. And I won't be able to properly enunciate and whatnot. Gustav, no good reason for it. Hi. Fuck! Oh god, I suck. Damn it, my anti-air didn't work! Oh my god. I really do suck. Ah, it didn't work! I thought if I kept going, like, I knew the first hit would whiff. I mean, there was no way the first hit of that was not going to whiff. But I was hoping that the third hit would still go through. Because I know I've done that a lot and I've just stopped, but... Oh god! Oh, fine. I was thinking right there, like, this is usually when they go into the mix-up part. I should totally mash. Ah, fuck you! That's a bad habit that I really need to rid myself of, is mashing, like, while I'm getting hit. Because, I mean, I get hit by every single one of those potential resets. Oh, God. Oh, okay, I guess mashing there is not a good idea. Damn it! Where's my anti-air? God damn it. Did you really just mash 5A on? Ooh, you bitch! I get so mad when I see that. There's no reason for it. Anyway, Tager versus Asriel. The problem is, like, if you play Asriel the way you would normally play Asriel, it's bad for Asriel. because a lot of his attacks, a lot of his pretty much all of his block strings that you would normally use have gaps in them that allow Tager to get 360 A's for free, right? So it doesn't look that bad on paper. It doesn't look that terribly bad on paper for Tager because of that fact. But the thing is like, once the Azreal player gets a little bit of understanding of the matchup and understands that that can happen for a lot of scenarios, all you have to do is just stop doing that, and then you just backdash everything. Like, you do something, and instead of going into the block string that would normally allow you to, you know, do whatever, you just backdash. And there's nothing Tager can do about it. He can't be like, oh, okay, well, let me throw out this poke. It'll hopefully catch the backdash. All of his pokes that have that range are too slow. It won't work. If you can just backdash, like, if you're Azreal, you can just backdash twice. Or something like that. You know, like, and then Azreal's neutral just shits all over Tager's. So there's no reason to bother with the wake-up guesses and games that occur on Tager's wake-up. Like, maybe you'll get 368. Maybe you'll get, you know, something. There's no reason to bother with it. You just backdash. You go back to the neutral game. And then you fucking fuck that dude up in the neutral game. Because Tager has no answers. Oh god! Totally teched it. But we're gonna match 5A. Fuck that. Oh. Ha! Oh god. Fuck you. Oh, my anti-air didn't work! How dare you? How dare you? Fuck you. Oh, not fuck you. Fuck me. Oh, shit. Confirmed off of it. Ah, oh, damn it. I was mashing. Don't be dead. 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 Yay, I'm not dead. Oh, I was mashing again. That's what I get. Like, the person was mashing 5A on me. Fuck that. I'm gonna mash 5A on you. It didn't work. Oops. Fine, I'll do it again. What? Like, what was that? Yo, no backdash. Shoutouts to that. I love not getting backdashes. So late on all techs. No DP, like, I did it three times just to, like, try and be sure that it would fucking come out, and it didn't. Oh god, I fucked that up, I fucked that up. I'm so passive aggressive. Well, that's not even passive aggressive. I'm playing a fighting game, I'm beating the shit out of you. I'm so aggressive aggressive. I'm a dick, though. I'll admit it. I'm a dick. But yeah, so I legitimately feel bad for, like, for anybody that, let me see. Money tag. Rossian Seis. Who are you, damn? Damn, damn, damn. Damn, damn, damn. We're gonna have to go check lobbies again, yo. We going to check lobbies again. Ah, no, wait, that person just got out of the match. I ain't no asshole that does that. People actually, that shit made me actually quit this last night. Because I was playing, and I was playing against this, surprisingly good Noelle player. I underestimated them because I started out they had the little blue icon, which, like I said before, the blue icon usually means that this person is not the highest quality player in the world. Like, generally, green is average, and then it's kind of every... Well, no, actually, like, well, basically, either one of the greens means you're pretty much, like, an average-level player. And so I take blue as to kind of mean, like, this person is learning the game, they haven't had it for as long as a lot of people. Yellow, I'm yellow, so I have to assume that they're at least somewhat decent, but they have their very scrubby moments. Because I know I have my very, 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 very scrubby moments. But yeah, anyway, so this Noelle player was blue, so I figured, okay, I'll use Bullet against them, because why not? Well, actually, I think we have... Not that one. Oh, this was the one where... This was the good lobby. And damn, did I get my ass kicked. I'm sad that I... Well, that actually... He wasn't actually a very good Ragna player. Where's the one? I'll show this one. This one. This person, I so wish... This was all in the... What's it called? The Finest KO lobby. All of these matches right here, like the about like the 7 or 8 matches right there, were all in the Finest KO lobby. And this dude had a zero bar connection, and I wish so hard. You have no idea how hard I wish that it was not a terrible, shitty connection. Because this dude's a good player. I mean, but you can also tell that the person is used to not having a good connection with people. You can always tell when somebody is used to having a bad connection, in contrast to somebody like me who tries to stay away from bad connections. Because, like, he hit everything. All of his confirms were on point. All of his combos were on point. I can't even do a Rekka in lag, and this dude is doing all, like, the highest level Ragna combos there are to do. But yeah, I mean, I really wish, because this dude was obviously a good Ragna player. And I need to fight a good Ragna player so terribly badly, just, like, nonstop. Because... I'm terrible against Ragna. I don't know what it is. I have always been completely free to Ragna, regardless of who I'm using. Doesn't matter which character I'm using, I am completely free to him. But you can always tell when a match is, like, hella laggy, because, like, when you're watching the replay at full speed again, you'll notice, like, before everything, every single thing you try to do, there's a little jerk in your motions. Like, the character twitches a little bit before the actual motion goes through. So, like, if you try to do a quarter circle motion, you'll see the character crouch first because you can't do it fast enough. If you try to backdash, you'll see the character take half a step back because you can't backdash fast enough. It's hilarious to watch. But you can't see it right here because I'm getting my ass kicked by Ragna. But, man, I have to say, I firmly believe... The Ragna players are the whiniest people in all... Oh, this is the match where I do. You're going to see some hella scrubby shit at the end of this round. I firmly believe Ragna players are the whiniest players that exist in BlazBlue. 100%. Ha! I'm a dick. Right here. Oh, no, not right here. Where was it? It must be after this. Oh, right here. I try to DP his, to bait out his DP, I try to use mine. Azrael's DP is like the worst DP in the game. I mean, technically it's not even a DP. Really, the entire point of that move is for the projectile absorption aspect. You're really not supposed to use it as a reversal because it is a terrible, terrible, terrible reversal. Oh, I didn't use Bullet against him, I used Terumi. It's this one. This is actually a surprise, and let's watch this one. Watch the one in the middle, I can't remember which one's which. Watch the one in the middle. The best, I mean, they obviously had a lot of work to do. They didn't have, like, 100% amazing combos or confirms. But they were basically the first Noelle player I have played that did not mash on D. So shoutouts to you for being the best Noelle player so far that I have played. But yeah, I'm completely free to Ragna. Don't know why. There must just be some block in my mind that I see Ragna and I'm free. Tager, Azrael, I feel bad whenever I play against Tager. I feel terribly. I mean, I don't feel bad for the dude that I just beat right there because, like, that was his own fault. He went from using a character that, like, I would say has an average matchup against Azrael to a character that has a terror. Like, you don't, when you use Erekuni, you don't fucking switch to Tager. You just don't do it. So I don't feel bad for that one at all, but when I just see somebody on the character select screen and their icon goes to Tager, I'm just like, oh.
You poor thing. Oh, you poor dear. I'm so sorry for what's about to happen. I picked the wrong, like, look, I'm gonna fast forward through this because I just, like, hyped this person up as being, like, a good Noelle player, and here's my ass Asrieling the shit out of them. Look at those confirms. Weren't those godlike confirms? Jesus Christ. I'm such a dick. There we go. Do stuff. Yes. Thank you. Although I wasn't sure. I mean, like, I have to... That can't be an optimal combo for Noelle because, like, he gave... Oh, now that I'm actually watching it. He gave up the corner. And then... But got the other corner back. So, shout-outs to them. God damn, I need to work on my footsies. Not necessarily my footsies, I need to work on my spacing. Spacing is so important. This dude, shout outs to you! Not shout outs to this whole thing. I don't know, oh god, what have I done? I don't know why I did that. I have no idea why I played all those Tager mirrors. But the person knew me because, like, we were in that lobby system. They were like, Nate! And I was like, okay, let's play. And then I picked Tager, and then he picked Tager, and I was like, ah, this dude watches my videos. Be a good dude. Don't just play him in the mirror match. Oh, God, I hate Tager mirror match. You have no idea how much I hate the Z-Tager mirror match. You know, I'm going to show you, because this person sent me a message as well. I'm assuming watched my videos because they knew, apparently I can't even hit the correct button. That would explain a lot of my problems. But yeah, this person sent me a message as well, and then I sent them a message back. Sorry. Because, I mean, you'll kind of see that, like, I was really, really not playing very well in this entire, like, this entire lobby. I just played terribly. But I still beat the Tager player because the poor bastard's using Tager. I feel so bad. I've never felt bad about, like, blowing people up before. I've never once felt bad, but this matchup makes me feel ugly inside. Because it's just so heavily not in their favor. It's one thing I really need to fucking work on. Desperately need to work on using barrier in the air, like jumping and then immediately burying. See, I'm like, how easy is that to confirm? You know how easy that shit is to confirm, and I fucked it up. But yeah, that was pretty much like all night long. I could not hit a combo. I don't know what it was. I don't know if I was just like tired. If I was just, wow, a rare moment where I actually hit that fucking move. Aw, damn it. I remember that. That's sad, man. Like, I hit, you have no idea. See? Like, that sucks. I have no idea how many 3Cs overall I actually hit. But I would say about 95% of them, I dropped the following 2-2C. Just throughout the night. Like, I could not do the fucking move. It was terrible. That was also a terrible DP. But that was God, well, that was almost godlike until I completely fucking missed the phalanx cannon. I think I would have punished that if I had woken up with a 5A. See, I can't even do that, and I didn't confirm that! I'm terrible! I mean, he should have... Well, I don't think, my knowledge of exactly how...